The Commission on Elections is holding a press briefing. Let's listen in.
AFP and the PNP, that we will work together so that people will feel secure. Although 15 election violent incidents, it's still a good low number to work on, and we hope that it continues to be low till the end of the day.
Thank you, Colonel Sagala. From the PNP, sir. General Noblesa.
Hello. Sir, for the Philippine National Police, we could say that these are only isolated cases. Happened particularly in the provinces of Balanao del Sur and in Maguindanao. There are places wherein there are shooting incidents happened and harassments, and also some in here in Luzon. But if you are going to compare this to the data during the last elections, as of now, we have just recorded, validated election-related incidents, which is 16. And if we are going to compare this to the previous elections, this number is still a little bit lower as compared to the previous elections. And the PNP could say that generally, the election that is happening now is generally peaceful. Thank you.
Thank you po. Kay Chairman's, kay Chairman Pangarungan, or kaya ka po kay Commissioner Ferolino. Ma'am, sir, may re-recommenda po ba or may kukonsidera ng COMELEC na i-declara na failure of election or i-extend po yung botohan doon sa mga lugar na meron pong naitalang mga kaguluhan o maraming problema, lalo na po yung mga VCM?
All these incidents will be forwarded to the Commission in Bank, and we might take action on all these election-related cases. Like, for example, kung may incident na involve yung mga filling of ballots by some candidates, the Commission in Bank might consider declaring a failure of election in certain voting centers, not the whole town. For example, in the case of Malabang, Lanao del Sur, ang nabalidit namin na namatay doon na isa between the two mayoral candidates. Casting of votes at the National High School in Malabang, where we have clustered precincts totaling 7,878. May report na in some precincts doon, after the shooting incident, medyo tumakbo yung mga tao doon sa presinto na yon, and yung kabila daw, they filled up the ballots. Now, we are still validating that. We required our election officer to submit a formal report, and we will act on that accordingly. But if ever we will declare a failure of election, maybe it is only for that particular voting center, not the result of the whole town of Malabang. Malabang is the biggest town in the second district of Lanao del Sur. So far, yun lang ang na-receive namin sa Malabang. In the case of Pilar naman, mukhang okay naman yung voting nila doon sa Pilar, Abra. May mga, may mga heated arguments during the voting, but not so serious naman. Okay?
Opo, Chairman, huli-hilit po na iba na mga nasa pila pa rin po sa mga oras na ito. At ilang oras na lang ba? Alas 7 na po magsasara ng mga presinto. Wala na po bang pag-asa na ma-extend yung voting hours po ngayon?
Ang batas, pagdating ng alas 7 ng gabi, kung may mga tao pa doon within the vicinity of that voting center na hindi pa nakakabuto, kailangan pabutuin yon. So we can extend the voting hours up to the time that we have accommodated everyone within that vicinity ng voting center.
Thank you po.
Thank you. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN.
Sir K. Chairman, sir, with that 15 incidents, yung violent incidents na nai-record po ng AFP and PNP, sa panig po ng COMELEC, will you still consider na generally peaceful ang election po natin?
As confirmed by our security partners, yung nakarang election 2019, ang number of violent incidents was 60. Ngayon, ang na-report lang is 15 incidents. So I would still consider this election as relatively peaceful compared to the elections in 2019.
Sir, sa PNP naman, particularly update lang dun sa encounter between armed men of mayoralty candidates sa General Tino Nueva Ecija. Baka may update po kayo?
General Tino Nueva Ecija daw po. General Noblesa, sir.
Sir, this incident happened last May 7. It was the shooting incident happened between the supporters of the mayoralty candidate in General Tino. And so far, sir, the PNP was able to confiscate plenty of numbers of firearms, such as M16 rifles, totaling to 5 M16 rifles, 11 caliber 45 pistols, 3 caliber 9mm pistols, 1 caliber 40 pistol, and 1 12-gauge shotgun. And when the PNP responded in the area of shooting, so sir, the PNP was able because there were wounded security personnel on the side of the mayoralty candidate Bute, and the suspects were arrested. So the PNP was able to arrest suspects, and the corresponding cases will be filed in court. And because of the recovery of the firearms and the crime scene, including the arrest of the suspects.
Sir, will you recommend na maisailalin sa areas of concern ng General Tino at yung touring po ng PNP sa ganun, since ang dami pong armed men, sila ba ay considered as private armed group ng local politicians?
So far, sir, this is not listed in our PNP, in the PNP list as private armed groups. But when we had a meeting this morning by the members of the Committee on the Ban on Firearms and Security Concerns, this place was not recommended under COMELEC control, because everything is still under control by the PNP, the AFP, and other security forces. And we are not recommending that this place, General Tino, be under COMELEC control. Thank you.
And lastly, for the record lang po, General, kailan ba maiko-consider na private armed group ang security personnel ng politiko? Considering na ang dami po nung naaresto sa General Tino.
Of course, if you are talking of private armed groups, so these are a group of persons that are confederating and helping each other for the advancement of one political candidate. So in this case, we could say that this group are private armed groups because of the firearms and the number of suspects that were arrested by the PNP.
And last, anong liability ng mayoralty candidate na nagko-control dun sa armed group?
Sir, we will still investigate, because investigation is still ongoing. So we would just furnish the COMELEC with the complete investigation of this particular case.
Thank you, po.
Thank you, Johnson. Martin Sadongdong of Manila Bulletin.
Hi, sirs. Good afternoon po. Sir, this question is addressed to Colonel Zagala and Brigadier General Nableza, sirs. Earlier, sir, you mentioned sa AFP we have 15 violent incidents and for the PNP we have 16 validated incidents. Can you just specify what type of incidents yung binabanggit natin? Are these shooting incidents, bomb attacks, etc.?
For the AFP, what was reported to us is 2 explosions, 2 shootings, 1 grenade throwing, 2 ambush, 2 arm clash between political rivals, indiscriminate firing isa, indiscriminate firing with ballot snatching isa, and strafing 3.
Sir, sorry, pasingat. Can you just specify din kung saang areas po ito? Thank you.
The strafing is in Buluan, Maguindanao. Explosion is in Barangay Poblacion, Kabakan, Cotabato. There's no casualty. Explosion in Barangay Daladagan in Magdadatu, Maguindanao. No casualty. Grenade throwing did not explode in Barangay Pag-asa in Kalamansig, Sultan Kudarat. The ambush is in Barangay Panapan in Magdadatu, Maguindanao. The arm clash is in Pandag, Maguindanao. Arm clash also is in Barangay Pagada in Maguindanao. Shooting in Malabang National High School in Malabang, Lanao del Sur. Shooting in Barangay Arsao in Malabang, Lanao del Sur. Ambush in Pandag, Maguindanao. The strafing in Barangay Lower Kabengbeng in Basilan. Strafing in Tong Umos Tupaan Island in Basilan Province. Ballot snatching in Basilan Province. Indiscriminate firing in Basilan Province, and another indiscriminate firing also in Basilan Province.
For the PNP, sir, thank you. Can you just specify, sir, what areas and what type of incidents yung nabanggit natin kanina na 16 validated incidents po? Thank you, sir.
General Nableza, sir.
Yes, sir. I'm talking about when the election period starts.
Yes.
So because we have all the data pertaining to the validated election-related incidents since the start of the election period, that was January 9 up to today. So based on our record, we have recorded a total of 4 validated incidents happened in Region 1, and Region 3, 5, Region 9 is 4, Region 10, 1, Cordillera is 2. But we still need to include all the incidents happened today.
So dun sa 16 incidents, sir, hindi pa kasama yung nangyari today,
yes,
sir?
Yes, all these incidents all the incidents happened today are not yet included in those incidents that I mentioned.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Sally Bueno, DWIC.
Sir, ngayong 1.5 hour na lang, magkuklose na yung mga polling precinct. Mas crucial ba yung mga susunod na oras pagdating sa security? Kasi may mga report na may ilang mga lugar na medyo maiinit po yung mga botante, lalo na yung mga hindi nga nila personally na ipasok yung kanilang mga balota dun sa mga nag-malfunction na mga VCM. Mas crucial po ba yung mga susunod na oras? And then mas i-intensify po ba yung security na ipatutupad?
Kanina po yung tanong, ma'am?
Siguro kay Chairman o kaya sa mga security.
Security forces, gentlemen. Colonel Sagala.
Of course, right now, our concern is security. No? So we've already laid out more or less almost 70,000 troops to support COMELEC and the Philippine National Police in all these areas of concern. So our duty now is to ensure that we stabilize, de-escalate the areas where there is possible violence so that we can allow our people to vote. So for us, it's very important that we continue till the end, no? Even until tomorrow, even the days after, no? So for us, our troops are there, although there are 16 violent incidents. For us, that is low, and we hope that it does not add, and we will continue our presence so that until 7 or beyond, our countrymen can vote. So it's very crucial that we continue. And the presence of more or less 70,000 members of the Armed Forces of Philippines will assure that.
To COMELEC Chairman, how soon po yung pagdidesisyon kung kinakailangan magkaroon ng declaration ng failure of election doon sa mga lugar na nagkaroon ho ng mga violence?
Actually, we have declared in our joint command conference that we will not encourage any failure of election. I stated that very clearly, na yung failure of election is not an option, but we cannot avoid it. Baka naman talagang kailangan mag-declare ng failure of election, but this is a decision that has to be made by the Commission in Bank. So, papasok yung petition sa amin, because, for example, maski ako, I'm the chairman, but I cannot do that, na mag-declare ng failure of election. Kailangan ang Commission in Bank ang mag-declare niyan. So, depende sa ipa-file na petition sa in Bank. So far, wala akong nakikita na malaking area na i-declare ng failure of elections. The whole day, we have been monitoring the security situation of the country. Ang nakita ko lang na maaaring may problema yung sa Malabang. Yung sa Malabang National High School na may isa ang namatay, and then there is an allegation that yung mga balota daw ay they were filled up by one particular candidate sa mayor. Kasi nung mamatay yung isa ay tumakbo yung kabila. So naiwanan sila doon, and then yun na ang ginawa nila, they filled up the ballots. But as I said, wala namang masyadong threat na nakita natin. For example, a threat from a bigger group like the New People's Army or the Communist Party of the Philippines, wala tayong nakitang threat from them. E malaking grupo yan. Or say, from the bigger organized group like the Abu Sayyaf, wala. The BIFF, wala. The Maute group, wala. Hindi natin nakita yung threat na violent acts ng itong malalaking grupo. Ang nagpenetrate dito yung mga private armed group ng mga politicians, which are considerably smaller, hindi malaki.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Chairman. Thank you, Sally. Other matters, Director Rex or Chairman or Commissioner Amy, what is the reason for early suspension of canvassing from Teleradio and the Philippine Star? Ano daw po yung dahilan, ma'am, at sinuspindi po ng maaga yung canvassing ng NBOC?
Today?
Yes po.
Yes. The ANBA through the chair, declare the early suspension since hindi pa naman talaga magtra-transmit yung ating mga VCMs. And the report from the VCMs will still has to pass through the MDOC and the PBOC. So ang remember na magko-close ang voting generally by 7 o'clock. So after that, saka pa magka-count. So there's no point waiting kasi wala pa naman talaga kaming marireceive na results. That's why we will resume tomorrow pag meron nang matatransmit to the NDOC.
Thank you, Comingi. Director Rex?
And to put into proper perspective po yung lahat, ano, this is not a postponement. It's merely a suspension of proceedings. Kumbaga po, akin to ay recess. A declaration of recess, continuing quorum po kami. Wala pong adjournment. Hindi po nag-adjourn ang NDOC. We will continue with having a continuing quorum and we will resume the session po tomorrow. So itama lang po namin terms, hindi po postponement. It's merely a suspension of proceedings or a declaration of recess which will resume tomorrow po. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Honors. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you, friends from the media. That concludes our 5 o'clock press briefing. Thank you.
And that was the COMELEC press conference for the election 2022. Just to give a quick rundown, they reported that there are 15 election-related violence incidents. General Nobreza from the PNP mentioned three areas in the Philippines where there were shooting incidents and harassments, 16 to be exact, which were Lanao del Sur, Maguindanao, and some parts of Luzon. But he did note that the numbers were high in the previous election, concluding, therefore, that the elections happening right now are relatively peaceful.